Hello, today we'll be reading a very old Benny and the Ink Machine roleplay from eons ago. Probably only like a couple months ago, but that's fine. It feels like eons ago.
The distant realm of 2019.
Yes, exactly. Metaton. Hello, runs into the studio. I am here. Sassy pose. Looks around. That's pretty canon. But no one came.
I already made two references in my head. I was going to say, oh, hello. And then I wanted him to do the All Might pose, but he didn't. And that makes me sad.
We can imagine he did the All Might pose.
I don't want to imagine him.
All Might's poses are pretty sassy.
I don't want to imagine him at all.
You can imagine a paper bag as him. There you go.
No, I'll get out my calculator and then say that's him.
Perfect. That's perfection. Metaton, walking around. Hello. But no one came, so he shut up and looked around. That is definitely you.
That's me.
That is definitely you.
I remember typing that too, and you're just like, dang, why is she so mad? We haven't even typed like 5 lines yet.
I know. I was like, you are triggered. Metaton looks around. Where's the people?
Do you want to say pizza?
Yes.
Where's the pizza I was promised?
I was going to say, where's the pizzeria? But obviously that's not what it says.
We're not in FNAF, Alex. Get the right game.
I guess I'm really hungry. And also very FNAF-y mood. Don't tell my sister I said that. Because she's obsessed with it. And she hears.
Same.
Metaton looks around. Where's the paparazzi I was promised? Looks around. Sees ink machine. Ew.
A crash can be heard. A board fell from the ceiling, almost hitting him. Just as a warning from me, the narrator, that I hate him.
As a narrator, you can do so many things to your characters.
I could have let it hit him. I could have let it hit him, right? But I was being nice.
I mean, yeah, it's like how I accidentally made Lotor walk into a tree.
Oh my god, yeah.
Accidentally.
Like, in a roleplay, she literally made him, like, trip over a rock, like, making his nose bleed, and then bumping into a tree head first.
I would say that it was part of the storyline and the plotline. But it wasn't.
It was just being a cruel person. Metaton. Oh, he jumps. Sweet mother of pink. Collects himself. Sees some item. Sees item pictures on wall. Sighs. Let me guess. I have to go around and collect these things. Of course I do. He goes and collects the items and then places them on the pedestal thing. The ink machine starts working. We just skipped like an entire first chapter.
Yeah, because it's a fetch quest.
Yeah, it's so annoying. Metaton. Great. Now it makes some noises.
And here comes the part that pisses me off almost the most.
It was so funny though. I sees Gundam. Oh dang, he's kinda hot. Gundam yells and runs after him. Oh wait. Oh, right. Gundam yells and runs after him. I had a moment where I thought Metaton was supposed to run after him, because that's something Metaton would do.
Oh my god, I'd freaking punch him.
Gundam yells and runs after him. Ah, hot demon. He runs and falls to the floorboard.
I'm gonna slap him one of these days, just for that freaking comment. Also, I'm gonna bring in another character just so I can type as someone. And this is like a reference to when I first learned what OCs were, and I was like making stuff for the fandoms that I liked. And like, I don't really keep with them anymore, and I've actually repurposed some to become a part of my original series. But this one kind of stayed just for like roleplays and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, Mr.
I remember this character too.
Yeah.
He's the Disney sidekick.
Actually,
I believe, yes.
More just like the cartoon sidekick that everybody loves for no reason.
True. He's the Mondu of Benny and the Ink Machine now.
A mystery character. They gasp and hide behind a pipe.
Metaton, what was that? Show yourself! Uses high heels as a weapon. Oh, that's actually kind of smart. Those things hurt.
I wouldn't know because I haven't even like seen a pair in my house. Like, let alone use one as a weapon. Mystery character.
I mean, fair point.
Peeps out from behind the pipe. Just for the narrators. This is the name of my the character, Splatter Inkson, a little baby searcher, because I thought that would be friggin' adorable.
It is adorable.
Mm-hmm.
It's on. Oh, anime eyes, you are just the cutest thing.
That is an insult to anime, excuse me. You are ruining anime, Metaton.
He kind of, like, is an anime character in and of himself.
My god, if he was an anime character, I would never, like, go near his anime.
He'd have an anime called Late Nights. Oh, no, he'd have a talk show, and it'd be called Late Nights with Metaton.
Ew.
That's gotta be a thing somewhere.
Oh, no, I don't want to look that up, but I also really want to know if somebody made that.
Hopefully someone did.
I don't want it. I don't want that in my life. Splatter comes out from behind the pipe and looks up at him.
Metaton, oh, crouches down. Hello there.
Splatter waves a little.
Metaton, just out of curiosity, do you know how to leave this place? I need my hourly outfit change and a new pair of heels.
My god, he's like everything that I don't like.
Oh my gosh. I used to be like that. Like, when I was a little kid, my mom told me that I used to change outfits at least 5 times a day just because I could.
Like, I'm the complete exact opposite. I've been wearing the same thing for, like, 2 days now.
Oh my gosh. Ever since quarantine hit, that's been me.
Yeah.
Wearing the exact same outfit every day.
Yeah, like, there's this one time. Remember that Gundam t-shirt my parents got me for my birthday?
Yeah. Oh
my god, my mom told me, like, to go change into something else because I had been wearing it for, like, 3 days or something. And I'm like, no, I like this t-shirt. I want to keep it on.
You're like, no, you can't make me. Just run away.
Splatter literally does not understand half of what he's saying. So he just glances down and chugs.
Metaton, oh, well, that's just great. First, my hot pink outfit looks red from all the goo, and now I can't get out.
That's not how color theory works. That's not how color works.
You know what? I was writing. I was just kind of going with it.
Swim, swim. Dorino sang me. Metaton is just being his normal stupid self.
Okay. Do you know someone who can help me?
Splatter thinks. Before he can nod, bum bum bum, first other character who can actually talk. Splatter, yay! Splatter, where are you? Splatter looks to where the voice is coming from.
Metaton, another person. Come on, little one. Who needs more pink? We have to go to the voice.
Splatter is perfect the way he is.
Oh my gosh, this gives me the same vibes as going towards the light.
I think I see a light. I'm gonna go towards it.
Don't go towards the light.
It's not that kind of light.
Okay, Splatter follows Metaton hesitantly, and after a while of talking, they come to the source of the voice. Splatter? Sees them. Oh, runs over and hugs Splatter. Oh my gosh, are you alright? Splatter nods and hugs back.
Finally, a real person! Jump up a little bit.
I'm a real boy. Stands up, picking up Splatter. Who are you?
Metaton flips hair. I am Metaton, smiles. And I am terribly lost. That's the most confident I am terribly lost I've ever heard in my life.
Oh my god. Nods. Well, I'm Riley. That's me. That's me in the roleplay. Look, it's me.
Oh my gosh, look, it's you.
I'm in this.
Metaton. Look, there I am.
Look, Mom, it's me.
I'm on TV.
I was on TV.
Metaton. Oh, it's very nice to meet you. Oh, I like your ears. Taps ear. Say, do you have a spare dress or something? Preferably pink.
I take a step back.
Do not touch.
No, I don't say that. Please don't do that, I say. Because, like, honestly, in this, I have no reason to be pissed off at him yet.
I forget why he asked about your ears. It was probably something with the character design.
I think it was because, like, I had, like, wolf ears or something. No, like, fox ears. Because since I'm replacing Boris, I made myself look like a fox.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I couldn't remember. I was thinking back. I'm like, why would he tap your ear? And I'm just thinking he goes up and taps your ear. And I'm like, that's a little weird.
What is it, like the first episode of Voltron?
Yeah. That's what I'm thinking. Metaton. Oh, sorry. flips hair. I'm just excited. He flips his hair a lot.
I know. You do. You make, like, your characters flip their hair so much.
I know. I just think it's hilarious for Mettaton to flip his hair. I think it's so funny.
Because it's not physically possible. Isn't it, like, made of metal or something?
I like to pretend that it's made of synthetic hair.
Okay. I nod.
Okay.
You said you were lost, right? Put Spotter on her shoulder.
Mettaton nods. I came here to see a fan, but no one was here.
I nod.
He comes again in to see a ceiling fan.
My ceiling fan is on right now, so.
Ba-dum-boom. Ba-dum-dum-dum.
There's probably a way out from down here. I could show you if you want.
Mettaton. Oh, thank you. Dramatic pose. I would appreciate it.
He just does, like, the Sailor Moon hands.
Oh my gosh, that would be amazing.
No, he's not that cultured.
Oh my gosh.
I nod awkwardly. What the frick is with this guy?
Mettaton gives her a big hug. Ugh, why is this place so dull?
May you turn to ash. Danganronpa 2 reference for no reason, because I love Gundam. I stiffen up. Well, it's mostly made of ink.
Mettaton. Well, you guys really need colored ink.
I shrug. Anyway, let's just get going.
Mettaton. Of course! And so they begin a long and slightly one-sided, aka Mettaton being pushy, friendship. Okay, that was definitely you typing that.
I think it was. I can't really remember.
It's I don't remember anymore. It's been so long.
It's been so long since last I've seen my son. I'm leading the way through the basement, trying to get to the music place. I can't remember what it's called.
Oof, felt that. Been a time. So I wanted to ask you, who's the hot demon?
Taken.
Oh my god! I'm sorry, I had a moment.
In come to deal with it, sunglasses.
Oh my gosh!
Hot demon?
Mettaton. Yeah. Tie, horns, scar over his eye, ice cream hair. You know, the cute one.
--. Did he really just... I'm not even gonna finish that thought. That must be Gundam.
Mettaton. Oh, so you know him! How is that? Is he your boyfriend? Because if so, that can only be bad for me.
Well, if it's bad for you, then yes. Me just, like, doing it out of spite. Okay, me. Blushies. I haven't typed that in a while. It's honestly really funny. At the mention of, you know, boyfriend, I sigh and rub my temples. Well, everybody knows everybody down here. And no, we're not dating.
Oh, so he's available.
Not what I said. Oh, stop putting words in my mouth.
I'm cracking myself up. I love typing for him. He's so funny.
Oh my god, especially because it pisses me off.
Yeah, that is kind of the fun of it.
But you know whose reactions are even funnier? Friggin' Aaron's.
Oh my god, Aaron's reactions? They are golden. For people who don't know Aaron's reactions, he just gets mad and he just tries to throw Mettaton off a bridge or something. Like, he just does something ridiculous like that.
And he always comes back to... Okay, I facepalm. No, that's not what I'm saying.
Oh, so he's not available. Oh, he must be dating someone else here then.
I shake my head no. Stop putting words in my mouth. Look, down here, we don't have the luxury of thinking about dating or relationships. We're just trying to survive.
Oh, so he's a bad boy.
I hate you so much.
Ew. Ew. I can't believe I typed that. But, like, even in the role play, I'm, like, aware that that's not something I wanted to type. Like, you can tell, like, dating mode? Is this what you would call this? Like, I'm not even sure what I'm doing.
Ha! Far from it.
Mettaton sprays perfume on himself, even though he's a robot.
Even though he doesn't have pockets. Really, I sneeze. Oh my god, like, perfume and cologne actually does, like, irritate my nose. Like, I'm not allergic or anything, but it just bothers me.
Certain body sprays bother me, like Axe body spray. Kids sprayed it in the classroom. Oh my god, worst thing that kid's ever done. Like,
oh my god. Remember that kid
that does not smell good.
Remember in our 7th grade reading class when there's that one kid who always had cologne on?
Yes. I don't remember who it was, but I remember you just walk by the kid and you just go, oh my god.
I think I remember who it was. I think I actually remember who it was, but I'm not going to say their name for, like, privacy reasons.
Yeah, that makes sense.
My god, but it bothered me so much. I kept feeling like I had to sneeze.
I sneeze a little. What's that smell?
Meditine. Daisy field.
And I'm just like, there's no daisy field in here. Are you stupid? And he's just like, yeah.
Meditan holds up his perfume bottle.
Oh, I nod. And I also turn away and sneeze again. He's so inconsiderate. I hate him.
Meditan puts it away. Now, that is a smell I like. That's such a weird statement. That is such a weird thing to say.
Can he even smell?
I should not know. Yeah, let's pretend he can. He's AI. He could probably do something crazy like that.
I guess. Spotter tugs on Riley's hair and points ahead of them. And I look where Spotter's pointing. Ugh, not again. Looks around and grabs an axe that's just conveniently sitting against the wall.